Sydney, March 31st, 2005, the Australian PEN announcement. The Indonesian publisher and editor, Joesoef Isak, is the inaugural recipient of the Australian PEN Keneally Award. The award is given by the Australian PEN Centres in recognition of Joesoef's achievement in promoting freedom of expression, international understanding, and access to literature, as expressed in the Charter of International PEN. The free world can quickly and sharply recognize ruthless dictators such as Pol Pot and Saddam Hussein, yet at the same time consider dictators such as General Suharto and General Pinochet to be friends of democracy. I consider the presentation of the Australian PEN Keneally Award to be correcting this error. Pramudia's translator, Max Lane. The establishment of Hasta Mitra in 1980 and the publications of their books were not just the first but also the open defiance in Indonesia against Suharto's military regime until he was ousted by the brave youth and students movement in 1998. Individual rights, freedom of expression, and human dignity are values which must be fought for by ourselves. Never hope that democratic values can be brought about by authoritarian rulers. Do not relent and never cease to resist oppression and injustice with the excuse of fatigue, despair, and moreover fear. The Australian PEN Keneally Award is a new award created on December 2004 by the Sydney and Canberra PEN Centres to recognise Thomas Keneally's lifetime commitment to the PEN values and also to his unflinching devotion to writers in detention. Joesoef Isak, former political detainee during Suharto's military regime, is the inaugural recipient of the award, and it was Thomas Keneally himself who presented the award to the awardee. In turn, Joesoef Isak, 25 years ago, translated and published Thomas Keneally's The Chant of Jimmy Blacksmith, a most haunting novel with a strong message of individual rights and human dignity. The book was not banned, like the other books of Hasta Mitra, but obviously Keneally's message on individual rights and human dignity did not seep into the hearts and minds of the generals in power, for Hasta Mitra's other books continued to be banned.
Thank you. Joesoef Isak is a publisher and a survivor. For 25 years, he has run the Indonesian publishing house Hasta, Mitra, despite political obstacles and in the face of great personal danger.
Don't get the impression that I want to be a hero. No, no. Nothing about that. Not a hero. It is just working for the good. Of course. Because I'm convinced you are contributing something small, but something. Upholding democracy. We need that.
In the summer of 1965, Sukarno was Indonesia's president. Joesoef Isak was a famous journalist and editor, a leading intellectual, and Sukarno favorite. In September, six of the country's most senior generals were dragged from their beds and murdered, the first in a series of events that ended in the overthrow of President Sukarno, the establishment of a militaristic regime by General Suharto, and the start of a campaign of terror, mass murder, and ideological cleansing.
In this environment, anyone who had any socialist leanings whatsoever was subject either to be slaughtered on the street or imprisoned. For Joesoef, he survived 2 years of interrogations and sporadic imprisonments before finally in 1967 he was imprisoned for a solid decade in a prison called Salemba, which where the conditions were really grim beyond imagining.
One day, out of the blue, my grandchildren, Marsha and Nabil, asked me whether it was true that I had been in prison. Correct. I admitted. That's true. That was a long time ago before they were born. I had been in prison as a political prisoner. The first time I was in prison as a journalist, and the second time as a publisher. Then I took the children with me to Salemba, the jail where I had been imprisoned for so many years. In front of the prison, I explained to the children the difference between a criminal and a political prisoner. I have nothing to hide. There is nothing to be ashamed of. And you too, I said to my grandchildren, must never be deterred by the truth.
In 1980, released from prison but denied basic freedoms and forbidden to return to his former work, Joesoef launched a publishing operation with two partners, also political prisoners. One was Pramudia Anantatur, Indonesia's most prominent author and most famous dissident. Pramudia's extraordinary works were most of what Hasta Mitra published. No other publisher would have dared touch them. The Suharto government banned nearly everything Hasta Mitra published, with severe penalties including years in prison for those caught distributing or discussing Hasta Mitra's books.